Hey guys, it's tsuksato. If you've got a little time and are interested in my stuff, I just opened commissions. Feel free to check out my payhip where I upload project files, editing packs, and even free stuff. Now let's dive into today's After Effects tutorial on how to make that flying Polaroid effect. Step 1. Prepare your clips. Get your clips ready. I usually do the Polaroid frame manually. Here's how. Mask the clip based on how you want the Polaroid to look. Duplicate the mask layer. On the duplicate, add the fill effect and set the color to white. Scale it up just a bit. Pull the lower part down slightly so it looks like a Polaroid frame. Once satisfied, pre-compose both layers. Step 2, adjust scale and rotation. On the pre-comp, scale it down so it fits well on screen. Press R to open rotation and set your preferred value. I use negative 26 degrees, but you can change this later. Pre-compose this layer again. Step 3, add CC cylinder. Apply the CC cylinder effect. Open rotation X, Y, Y, Z and add keyframes for all axes. Play around with the values. No fixed settings here. I usually use rotation order X, Y, Z, but feel free to explore. Adjust the radius if it looks too curved. Increasing it makes it flatter and more natural. Step 4, light and shading. This is super important. It gives life to the clip. Go to the light and shading settings under CC Cylinder. Tweak them until you get that highlighted dynamic look. Step 5. Keyframe animation, press P to open position. Add keyframes so the clip slides in at the beginning, slides out at the end. Optional but recommended for that flying feel. Step 6. Easy ease and graph. Select all keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. Then go into the graph editor and adjust for smoother motion. And that's it. You now have your very own flying Polaroid effect. Thanks for watching. And again, check out my payhip for resources, project files, and editing packs.